Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Tonight I'm here live with my beautiful model Cindy, and I'm going to be doing another one of my live makeovers for you guys. And tonight we're going to play with color because we haven't done that much yet. So I'm going to go ahead and get started on her brows. I'm going to take my Anastasia brow palette and I'm going to go into the color Ebony because she has really dark black hair. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to define her brows fairly dark tonight. So I'm just dipping into my powder and I'm just patting that on because I want to pack the color in. I want the color to be a little bit darker on the tail of her brows because that's naturally where most people's hair is a little bit more sparse. So I just want to fill that in. And then once I get to the front of her brows, I'm just going to draw on actual little hairs so that it looks a little bit more natural. I'm just starting with a small line. And I'll thicken it up as I go. And I always want the brows to be in balance with the face. So usually I follow what they have. And she has a fairly thick natural brow, but I don't want the brows to be too overpowering tonight. So I'm keeping them probably a medium thickness. And I really like the arch of the brow to be nice and defined. So I start there and I get a nice clean line. And then I lightly fill in the top, and then I just draw little hair strokes throughout the brow. And if you don't know the shape that your brow should be, it really helps to get them professionally shaped. That way you can see where your arch needs to be, and where they need to start, where they need to stop. It's super helpful, especially for people who have like a nice thick brow like you. Forward just a little bit. It's helpful to know. I think the hardest part for most people is to know where their little arch should be.
Yeah, that's true. It's my face.
Yeah. And it's totally preference to the shape. I like a bit of an arch. I think it's pretty. Some people like a really flat brow. But I just follow, you naturally have a little bit of an arch, and I think it's really pretty, so I'm just gonna follow that. And now that I'm up front, I'm gonna start drawing softer strokes. I'm gonna go in and just draw little hairs right at the front, just so that it's not too bold. I don't want a blocky-looking brow. I want it to look, even though we're filling them in and we're filling them in fairly bold, I want them to still be believable
No, yeah.
as if they were real.
Yeah.
So I like it more of a natural brow. These are really pretty. I love brows. I always say I'm like skin, brows, lashes. Those are my favorite things.
Yeah.
Make the biggest difference. That's kind of why I always start with brows too. I like to define that shape and then I play off with the eyeshadows and stuff like that. You can do any order you like. Some people like to do their brows after their foundation. I like to do it before.
So it's better doing it before.
It really just depends. I like to do it before because I feel like when I go in with my foundation, it'll kind of rub some of the brows off.
Yeah, that's true.
So I like to do them. Well, and it depends. I like to do them first so that I can outline them with concealer. But if you do them after, then you won't rub them off. So I take my little spoolie. I'm just gonna soften through the tail lightly, and then I'm gonna step back, make sure they look even. They do. They're so pretty. And then I'm gonna move on, and we're gonna go ahead and conceal her lid. We're gonna prime it with concealer. This is Tarte Shape Tape and Light Sand. I want to play up the yellow undertones in her skin today, so I'm gonna be highlighting her later on with this yellow concealer. So I'm going to put this, go ahead and close, on as an eyeshadow base, and I'm also gonna edge around her brows. I'm just gonna follow that shape I already did and use this concealer brush and just lightly draw around the brows just to define them. And this also creates a barrier for me when I do apply the foundation. Like I was telling you, like it'll have a little layer of concealer so I don't have to rub it off with the foundation. That color was a little bit too light, so mix swipe my brush and just make the tip really sharp so that when I go around the brush or the brow, it's a nice clean line. Just edging just lightly all the way around, and then I'll buff it out with my beauty blender. You just want to be careful. You don't want to cover up what you already did. You just want to outline it.
It has to be a lighter.
This one you want to be more your skin color, so I just darkened it up a little bit. Some people do lighter. If you really want your brows to pop, you can go lighter. But you need to be careful because
it's gonna
it can look a little bit weird. That's kind of like a stage makeup technique. Like, it really just makes your brows pop, and sometimes it looks great. Like, if you do like a full glam contour and you totally contour so dark and you highlight so light, definitely like outline your brows lighter. But in general, getting close for me. And just lightly. Just putting this as a primer over her lid. Patting it. Basically, what I'm doing with the beauty blender is spreading things around and absorbing any excess product. So I just want a really light layer. Since I'm going to be applying shadows over top of this, I don't want a really heavy layer. Just adding more concealer on my palette. This concealer, this Tarte Shape Tape, they come, I think, in at least 20 different shades. So you can get your shade that's your match. But in my kit, I like to keep things smaller so I don't have 20 products to sift through. So I always mix. So if you watch any of my videos, I'm probably mixing two or three things. Mm-hmm. But if you really like the product, there's definitely one match for you out there. Their concealers are nice because they have a bunch of different undertones. They have pink, they have yellow, they have peach. So I buy in like light, medium, dark, I buy just one of each undertone and then I can mix. With your skin tone, I like the yellow and the peaches. Great, now that that's on, I just want to prepare her lid for the shadows. So I'm going to go in with a fluffy blending brush, and I'm going to be using tonight the Too Faced Just Peachy Mattes palette. It's one of their new ones, and it smells like peaches.
Yeah,
it's so delicious. You're going to be able to smell it. And I'm going to go into this color Peach Butter, and I'm just going to really lightly go ahead and close dust all over the lid, and that's going to lock in this concealer and just prepare the lid for the shadows. This keeps it from creasing too. That I'm going to switch brushes to something a little bit smaller, just a nice fluffy dome brush, and we're going to go into the shade Just Peachy. It's like a light peach color, and I'm just going to brush that right through her crease. So we're going to do like a plum burgundy soft smoky eye on her, and then this peachy color in the crease. It's going to be really pretty. I love berries and peaches on dark brown hair. I think it's so pretty. So I'm excited to play with those colors on you. And I love neutrals, honestly. Like, we were talking about it before, and
yeah,
she said.
Yeah, I use more neutrals and brown.
Me too. They're just pretty. Like, they just flatter everybody, but I've done a lot of that on my channel so far because I haven't done too many makeovers, so I wanted to play with color tonight.
Perfect.
So I'm just going right in the crease, and now I'm going to go in with the darker color, this Peach Punch. Same brush. And I'm just going to add, this just adds a little bit more of a pop of color. I'm just swiping it right through that crease. This one's more of like a pink tone.
You're putting that in the corners?
In the corner and then in the crease.
In the crease.
Go over with purpley all of your emotions. Just spread it around. And I'm going in with a really light hand. I don't want a stripe of this. This is going to be the blend that will blend my darker shadows. So I'm doing the blend first, and then I'm going to lay on the darker shadows so everything looks a lot more seamless. Mm-hmm. Very pretty. Okay. Now I'm going to go in with this color just right with a flat brush, a flat shader brush. Go ahead and close. And I'm going to pack this all over the lid, tap off my brush so I don't have any fallout. And I'm going to start right at the base of the lash line because that's where I want the color to be darkest. So wherever you first set your brush is where the color is going to be darkest. It also helps you to blend too if you get all that pigment right at the base. Mm-hmm. As you move upward, you don't have as much left on your brush, so you can just really lightly blend it into the rest. So I'm basically just blending as I go. And I'm doing a nice, with this darker color, I'm doing a dome shape and I'm bringing it right up to her crease. She has more of a narrow lid space where her lash line's a little bit closer to her brows, so I don't want to bring the color up too high. I love it though. They're pretty. You have like the sultry, smoky eyes. So same thing on this side, just packing it right on the crease. And then buffing it up. And if you blend as you go, it's so much easier. You don't have to, like, I think the tendency when people do a smoky look is to pack on a ton of powder and then be like, okay, now I have to blend it. What am I gonna do? Go ahead and close. Especially when your crease isn't as large. Like, some people have a really big lid and they have this huge crease area. I don't either. So, you don't have as much room to blend. So, if you do it this way, it's already done. Mm-hmm. It's easy peasy. Mm-hmm. And this shadow is very pigmented, but it does, you do have to do a couple layers, which I actually like. It helps it blend. Just packing on by the lid and blending it up. So I am going to blend it slightly. So if she closes her eyes, my blend is pretty much done. I'm just really lightly going to take a domed brush and go through the crease just to blend those two colors together a little bit more. But it's super easy. It was pretty much done for me already. I like the way that looks. I'm probably going to take an even smaller brush and pack on a little bit more right by her crease because I do want that to be pretty smoky. I'm going to do a black liner with this look, so I want the base to be darker. So I was using... I'll show you. I was using this flat brush, so I'm going to go in with a smaller one. And just go right up against the base. Go ahead and close. And just pack it in right against that lash line. And in the middle of the lid. That's where I want all the color to be. Mm-hmm. You can see the more I layer it, the more of the color's undertones pop. Like it looks like a true plum. Sometimes if you just do a light wash, it's not as... not as dark. So I am doing packing. Whenever you place color, you press. When you blend, you swipe. Okay. And another trick to blending on a smaller lid space is to not actually take that color all the way up to the crease. And then when you're closed, you can just lightly blend it up with a fluffy brush. That way you don't get a line. Awesome, that looks great. I'm just gonna clean up under the eyes and then do the liner. Go ahead and look up for me. This is actually a super simple look. We just used three colors. I'm just gonna wipe under her eyes and pull it up to a nice V shape so I give her eyes some lift. I love the way that looks. And this prepares you for the liner too. If you do a little bit of a wing, you'll see it already with the concealer. Great.
Sometimes I feel like when I do, it's too rounded.
The liner?
No, the eyeshadow. Oh, so yeah. That's why you're doing
Yes, that's a good trick. Yeah, that helps a ton. little bit more of that shadow. Getting close. Yeah, that is definitely a good trick. Because some people's do, their eyes tend to look more round. So if you do that trick, it just ease it out a little bit more. Just going in with an even smaller brush and just blending over that area again, same thing. Just blending it right over everywhere we worked. And the blend can go up a little bit higher, closer to the inside of the brows. You don't want to touch it, but you can blend up a little bit higher there. Close. And do our liner. I'm gonna go in. This is Tarte Clay Paint Liner, and it's awesome because it's kind of like a mix between a gel and a liquid.
Oh yeah.
It's cool. So I'm gonna put it on my palette that your concealer is already on and just squeeze a little out. It's kind of like a runny gel.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes with this awesome.
When you buy it, it comes with
It doesn't come with the palette, it comes with a little angle brush.
Oh.
So it's kind of like liquid liner, like it, but you, it has its own little brush.
That's
so you can
cute.
Put it on the back of your hand or on a palette or something. Go ahead and close. And the brush is angled, so you don't have to hold it at a weird angle.
Mm-hmm.
You can just
yeah.
tilt it. I haven't used an angled brush on myself, but I feel like it would be helpful. I'm going to keep her wing small. I don't want to wing her out too big. And this glides on so easy. It really feels like liquid liner, just with like a brush. It's kind of wet. I like it. But it dries matte. And it's waterproof.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. I'm just doing small little strokes just so that I get it even. Lifting her brow a little bit just to smooth out the lid. Go ahead and open for me and look this way. Yes. Perfect. I'm just going to get right in your tear duct. Good job. Perfect. Okay. I'm going to do the other side. Go ahead and close. Yes. Perfect. Same thing, just short little strokes. And everyone has different methods. You can just do one big swipe across your eye, but I feel like it's easier to get a clean line. Just do little strokes. Alright, go ahead and open and look down. Yes, right there. I'm just going to do this inside corner again. When eyes are closed, it crinkles up in here, so it's hard for me to get a nice clean line. Okay. Go ahead and look forward, kind of at me. Good, okay, close. Perfect. Good job. I'm doing a slightly thicker line because the lashes I'm going to use on her have a thick band, so I want some liner to still be showing. Great, I'm just going to go in with a angled brush. And just clean it up a little bit. So this is actually the same type of brush I was using on her brows. It's just a MAC angled brush. And I like them. Go ahead and close. Because they're really stiff and they hold their shape really well. So it's easy to get a nice sharp line. Same thing, just little strokes, just cleaning everything up. This brush is easier to get a sharp little wing with because it's so stiff at the ends. I'm not doing a very long wing on her. I don't want this look to be all about the wing. I want it to be more about the lashes and the smoky shadow. All right, so now that that is on, I'm gonna move on to her complexion and do her face. Okay, go ahead and turn forward. Perfect. I like to do the face and then the lashes so that the lashes don't get foundation on them when people blink.
Oh, yeah.
So I like to have it set with powder. So I'm just going to go in with a damp beauty blender again and just press this into her skin. Just get a nice buffed airbrushed finish. And I'll buff it right into her hairline. Even look. And I prepped her skin before we started with some moisturizer just to make things really hydrated so the foundation doesn't look patchy. It's dry here in Southern California.
Yeah.
We need to be hydrated.
My lips are always dry.
Yes. Yeah, everyone's lips are dry. Helps to drink lots of water, but I don't know, it's so dry sometimes. Mm-hmm. It's not always that, but if you're not a big water drinker, that's a good place to start. It's gonna go around your nose. I like the beauty blenders because they're pointed at the tip, so you can get in those little crevices. Lightly blend down her neck. Your skin tone is very even. Most people are set like their neck is very white, their chest has a lot of color, like your is perfect. Yeah, it's so even. That's good. Do you wear sunscreen?
Yeah, and okay. I put in my neck too.
You do? Okay,
maybe
good.
That's why.
I'm gonna turn you a little bit towards me. Yeah, perfect. Mm-hmm. Way to go.
In my ears, too.
On your ears?
I like.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah.
I do, too. Sometimes I even put it in my part. Because I don't want, like, to get burned. I want skin damage on my head. My hair will stop growing. That's not good. Okay, so I'm going to go in with, I'm going to see. This is the light sand. It might be a little bit too light. I am going to highlight her a little bit. So this might be fine. But I don't like to go too dramatic with my highlight. Let's mix in a teeny, teeny bit of the light medium honey. So we're gonna mix the light sand and the light medium honey. And mix those two together, because if you go too light, sometimes it can look a little bit like chalky.
Yeah,
like you want it to warm you up and to brighten you, not to make you look ghostly or unhealthy. But I do want that light shade. The light medium honey is very pretty on you because it does have that honey undertone. I'm gonna lighten it up a little bit. The light sand on you is a little bit too.
So how tones lower you recommend?
So probably for sure no more than three, I would say. And that's if you want to highlight. If you're just concealing like a quick, simple look, just like half a shade at the most.
Okay.
Yeah, I only go brighter if I'm going to bring it down. So I'm just going to draw a little triangle. Usually the under eye area, it's different than the rest of the skin. So even if you do the same shade, you usually need to use a different concealer. Just because normal foundation is usually a little bit mattifying. So I'm just going to go on the sides of the nose a little bit. Right there. Find the cupid's bow, down the bridge of the nose, a little dot on the tip, and then just really lightly, middle of her forehead. Okay, I'm gonna go in with the beauty blender and just lightly press it into her skin. I want to keep it in the same area because this is lighter. Mm-hmm. I don't want to drag it out further because I don't want to make you look lighter.
Yeah.
I just want you to look highlighted. Mm-hmm. So the beauty sponge, with it being just a little bit damp, if it's too wet, it won't work. But if it's just slightly damp, it'll absorb some of the extra product. It's really just keeping things in their own little zone. Pressing it right in, right into the skin, keeping it in its same little area. And I didn't need to do any corrective contour on here, but you can really change the face if you want to. A lot of times people will do their forehead, like if their forehead is a little bit too big, you can definitely do some darker contour.
Now that I'm pregnant, for example, I think my face shabby, so.
Oh yeah, you get a little more flexible. Yeah. You don't look like it, but a lot of people say that.
Yeah.
So we'll contour you a little then. Yeah, so you can make things look bigger with the highlight. So anything light will make it look bigger. It makes it come forward. And darker recedes things, so it'll make it look smaller. So if we want to make your face look more narrow, we'll do it with the contour.
Okay.
Usually everyone can do a good cheek contour, no matter your face shape, it looks nice. Mm-hmm. So I'm just really being careful where I'm pressing this in. I don't, like I said, I don't want to spread this around, and I don't want it to come up too close to her eyes. Just right underneath. Perfect. Look up for me. I'm going to get right under here. And after I do the lashes, I'm going to put some warm shadow under her eyes too. I'm just meeting that little line where we sculpted it out before. Look up for me. And this concealer is self-setting. You don't need to powder over it. So as it's nice. So as I'm pressing it, it's like mattifying a little bit. And if I keep working it with the BB Blender, it doesn't crease. Great. So now that is done, and I'm gonna go in with some powders. So I'm gonna do a light wash of translucent powder. This is Laura Mercier. I love it. Do you have it? My favorite. It's so good. And it is just a translucent powder. It doesn't have any tint to it. So I'm just gonna do a really light wash over everything we've done. That way when I go in with the contour colors, it's not gonna to grab onto the product. If you go on with the darker shade onto like the wet foundation, it'll just stick. So if you have this one first, I'll grab it a little bit better. And I'm going to put just a teeny, teeny bit under her eyes to brighten it up. Look up for me. Just lightly dabbing it on. And definitely pay attention to how much product you're putting under the eyes. You don't want to put a lot of powder in there.
Yeah.
That's no good. But if you do more of a highlight with this concealer, it does help to set it a little bit. It'll last longer. But if you just do a light wash, you don't need to. Okay, so now that that is on, I'm going to go in with some contour. So I'm going to take an angled brush, and I'm going to go in my Anastasia contour kit, and I'm going to go in with this color. It's called Mink, and this one's a neutral tone. So I'm going to go in and just really lightly dust over her forehead. I'm just going to do a nice little arch. And she has a nice shaped forehead, so I don't want to make it look bigger, and I don't want to make it look smaller, so I'm really just keeping it right by her hairline. I'm doing a mix of pressing and swiping motions. I'm swiping to blend it so it doesn't look spotty, but I'm pressing just to press the color in because I don't want to rub off the foundation I just put on. So I'm just buffing that in, and now I'm going to take the edge of the angled brush and just swipe under her cheekbones. So I'm going right under them, and I'm curving it up a little bit to give the illusion of a nice round cheekbone. Just kind of cut into her face. And we'll do the sides of her face too. So all around the jawline. Same thing over here. You can do a lot with contouring. You can draw a whole new jaw if you wanted to. Depends on what it's for.
To look more.
Yes, more sculpted.
More.
You have a nice jawline. For you, I'm mostly just defining your nice cheekbones. So I like to press it in with that angled brush and then buff it out with like a rounder powder brush so it's not too harsh. Same thing over here. Okay, now that that is done, I'm gonna go in. This is Too Faced. This is the, and you might have this because you have the chocolate powder. This is the Chocolate Soleil bronzer. Have you used this before?
No.
It's super awesome. Mm-hmm. It smells like chocolate too.
Yeah.
And I'm just gonna warm you up. I like to contour with a neutral color so it looks like a natural shadow. And then I like to warm up the face with the bronzer.
So it is a shadow, or it's a
contour? Yeah, so this one's like kind of like a warmer contour. Mm-hmm. So I can go over your contour and just warm it up a little bit. It's a little bit like a bronzer, but it's matte. It doesn't have shimmer in it, which is good. All right, now that I've done that, I want to carve out her cheekbones a little bit more. So I'm going to put more of my translucent powder into the dish and take my beauty blender and utilize that little tip again. I'm just going to take that translucent powder and draw right under her cheekbones. And what this is going to do is sculpt out that contour and it's going to lighten right underneath of it. It's called baking.
The bake.
The bake. Baking the bake is like a little cake. Okay, turn towards me. I won't be able to see. So I want the contour line to be not like sharp where it's not realistic, but I want it to be more sculpted. Mm-hmm. So I'm going right underneath that line and I'm swiping up just to define her cheekbones. And what this is gonna do is why I let it sit on here, it's gonna lighten slightly. So I'm gonna leave this on when I do her lashes and her lips and then I'm gonna wipe it off. And it will just have more of a blended transition of that contour. So I'm gonna do the same thing down the tip of her nose. Beauty blenders are the best. It's like having five brushes. It's doing so many things for me. Sometimes I do a little bit on the forehead and a little bit right there. Just a little. Okay, awesome. So while that sits, I'm gonna go in and do the lashes. I am so excited. These are so many. She's excited too. We both love lashes. These are House of Lashes. I'm gonna have to look up the names for you guys. I keep them in a little lash book and I have the names written down but not underneath them. I'll put it in the description below. And I am using the House of Lashes glue in black. This is my favorite glue. It smells like flowers. I don't know if you can smell it. It smells good. All right. I like this glue because it dries really fast. So we're just gonna let it dry. We're gonna put it on into your lips. So we're gonna do a fun berry color on her lips today to match the plum shadows. Go ahead and look down. Go ahead and flutter for me. Go ahead and keep looking down. And they're gonna feel weird until they're dry. Because this is a thicker band, so it's gonna feel heavy. And these thicker bands, depending on people's eye shape, just using some hand sanitizer, sometimes they'll lift, so you just have to watch it while it dries, like keep an eye on it. And that's why I like tweezers, you can get in nice and close, you can use your fingers too, and just make sure as it dries, it's like pressed to the lash line. So I'm gonna go in with the other ones. And we did trim these quite a bit to fit her eyes, so we just did that before we started. And I always trim from the outside edge. That way the shape stays intact. If you cut from the inside, like the tear ducts of your eyes, it'll make the shape look kind of off. And then after I get the glue on, while I'm waiting for it to dry, I like to shape the lash and make it look more curved, because then it fits the eye a lot better. That's usually the problem. The thick bands just want to like straight up, like down for me. And that's what makes them pop off in those inner corners. So just tilt it. All right, look down. Good. Great. And these thicker bands look ready, definitely. Have to keep an eye on them. Okay. Especially those inside corners. So I just kind of hold it with the tweezers or hold it with my fingers and just let it dry. Because once it dries on the lid, it's not going to move. This is strong glue. And these lashes, this House of Lashes brand, you can wear multiple times. Just pull them off, don't get them wet, and then peel off the glue and stick them in their little, I'll give you their box they came in.
How do you clean the glue?
I just pull it off. Like, once you take it off of your lid, you can just peel it. Yeah. Open, look at me. Good. So pretty. Look down. I love these. They're amazing, and I'm just going to make sure that there wasn't any glue on her lid. Not that. Look up for me. Just cleaning up anything. A little bit of black glue. There. Okay, you can look down for me. I'm going to do your lips. We're going to go into the Anastasia lip kit, and we're going to do color number 9, actually number 10, and it's berry. And I might mix a little bit of brown with it. We'll see. Let's see. It's pretty bright. I don't know. No, let's do this berry. Let's go for it. Let's go bold. It's pretty on you. I really love this lip palette. It comes with 12 colors, and then it comes with white, black, red, yellow.
Yeah, I can see that. Yellow.
Yeah, and they're actually mixed in shades. I mean, you can wear the yellow as a lipstick if you wanted. It's made as like an adjuster. So like if I wanted this to be like a peachy berry, I could add yellow in, and it makes it more like orangey because yellow, red, this is kind of like a red make orange. So it's really fun. So you basically can make any color you want, which I love. It brings out like the art nerd in me. Like I like to look at like pictures of lipstick and then try to make it on my hand and yeah. Stuff. It's fun. Any color. These are really good lipsticks too because they dry a little bit matte, and anything matte is very long wearing. I love this color in you. It's so pretty. It's kind of like a fuchsia berry. It's very pink. Do you wear pink, Summer?
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Mostly red. I don't know why, but
red. Red. Yeah. It's so pretty on you. Definitely. Red is universally flattering. I feel like everybody can wear red. You just have to know your undertone. Are you blue red? Are you orange red? Are you neutral red?
I like more the blue.
The blue.
For example, pretty. I love the ruby wool in MAC.
Yes,
that's my favorite.
So good. That's such a good red. So,
yeah.
That is the perfect blue base red. Yeah, Ruby Roo, I think, is their best-selling red. That and, I think, Russian Red a lot of people like, too. But Ruby Roo,
yeah.
So good. Whenever I do bright colors, I like the lips to look super precise and clean because they're so bright.
Yeah.
It looks better that way. You can see every little line. So sometimes I go in around it with concealer and just sharpen up that line. I had, and it's all about the lip brush too. If it's in a tube, a lipstick, you could get a pretty clean line. But when I do clients, I have to like use a separate lip brush and stuff.
Oh yeah.
And I had this lip brush that I loved. I like anything that's really flat and sharp around the edges, but it's years and years old, and so it like started to fray and it's not as sharp anymore, but I can't find it. Like it was like some random brand. It's like on the hunt for a perfect lip brush. I still haven't found it, but I have some good ones. This one's pretty good. This one actually came with that palette. It has like a little spatula so you can scoop it out.
Nice.
Yeah. You can mix it and then use the brush, so that's nice. And the lip thing came with a palette like this too.
Oh, cool.
So that's all you need. It's really fun. It's good if you like to play with red colors because it has the red and then it has all the adjusters. Like you can mix the actual blue in it or yellow or whatever mm-hmm. you want until you find your perfect red. Open for me a little lighter. Good. Just want to get in that corner. I always like to go all the way to the corner so you don't have like floating lips.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to clean up the set. I'm going to turn you a little bit more. Oh, that's better. Hopefully the camera can still see what I'm doing. Yeah, I love this color in you. It's very bright, but it's so pretty. It probably has, I would say, a blue undertone too. I think things with the blue undertone look really good on you. It's like that berry sort of fuchsia look. And you can deepen it too, like the black color that's in the palette. You can darken everything.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And it looks like that, like that berry color. Okay, love it, gorgeous. Gonna clean off her bake, don't forget to do that so she doesn't have white lines on her cheek. That's no good. Okay, and then I'm gonna go in, after I do the lips, I like to go in and do the blush, the glow, the under eyes. So I'm gonna go in actually with this really pink, it looks crazy pink, but it's gonna look good. So I'm going in with my blush brush and just doing just the apples of her cheeks and so light. This is a fairly strong color. I just want to put color in her face because her lips are so bold. I want her cheeks to have something too. But I don't want it to look like stage makeup at the same time since we went so bright, so I'm not doing like a heavy blush, just like a light flush of color. So pretty. I actually love that color. I think it's called Stay Pretty. It's by MAC, but it
Stay
is
pretty.
Great. Yeah, it's so pretty. It actually looks really good with reds too, because it's just like a bright pink. Have some bake on your nose. Okay, and I'm gonna go in with the Anastasia Glow Kit. Let's do Glow Getter. It's like a golden. I'm gonna use my finger because I wanna press it right in. You can use a brush, but sometimes when you use a brush, it looks a little more glittery.
Oh, yeah.
Can you notice that? Do you like highlighters?
Yeah.
If you use your finger, it just presses it. Like, it literally just looks like your skin is glowing. So I'm doing the tops of her cheekbone and bringing it up a little bit, like a little bit of a C shape. I'm going to do down the bridge of her nose. You want to make sure you do this right in the center so you don't give her a crooked nose.
Oh, yeah.
That's no good. I like to do a little dot on the tip. I don't like too much highlighter on the nose, but I do like just a little bit. Yeah, that's really pretty. And I want it to be even a little bit brighter. So I am going to go in with a brush. Clean up the lips a little bit more, and then I'm gonna go in and finish her eyes. Okay, go ahead and relax your lips for me. Okay. Switch brushes. This is. This one's a little more flat. Let's clean this up. This is where you can really play with the shape of your lips too, this cupid bow. I don't like it to be too rounded. Some people like it really sharp. Maybe turn it a little bit, good. Be a good fall color too if you deepen it up a little bit. I love those like the really deep berries for fall. It's super pretty. Okay, now I'm just gonna do under her eyes a little bit. I'm gonna go in with that and a little bit of peach tea and a little bit of peach tart. So the same colors we did on her lid. So first I'm going to go in with a fluffy rounding brush and do some of this peach tea. Look up for me and go all the way under her eyes just to brighten it up. And then I'm going to do almost like a liner with the peach tart, that plum color that we did all over her lid. So the peach tea that we're doing, it just brightens everything. That's what's going to give it that peachy look. And then the peach, or just ripe is what it's called. Just reading the wrong one. Okay, so now that I warmed that up, I'm gonna go in, look up for me, concealer to crease. And I'm gonna go in with a smaller, like flat shader brush. And I'm just gonna do like a little bit of a line with that just right color, look up for me, right into her lash line. So this is almost like a bottom liner, basically. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna stop halfway through and dust it down just a little bit. Same thing on the other eye. I like to diffuse it, so I'm just dusting it down slightly. And now I'm going to add some eyeliner mascara. My little spoolie. And I really like to use the mascara to blend the natural lashes and the extensions. Go ahead and look down. I'm just going to pull up your lid and just press them together, basically. Your own natural lashes blend pretty well, but some people's really separate. These inside ones tend to point down, so I'm just pressing them together and darkening up your natural lashes to blend in with the extensions. And look up for me, I'm gonna get your bottom. Unless I'm doing a look where there's nothing on the bottom, like a old-fashioned cat eye or something, I always do bottom mascara. You do too.
I need. I
like it. It makes the eyes look bigger. All right. So pretty. I'm just going to clean it up a little bit. I love these lashes on you. I'm excited for you to see.
It's all done.
It's all done. Whoa. We're all done. You're gonna see. I'll give you a mirror.
Yay.
I know, yay. Gorgeous. Here you go.
Oh my god. Wow.
It's pretty. Do you like the
color? I love the. I never tried.
It's pretty on you. Yeah. I really like it.
So I'm definitely gonna buy that palette.
Yes. Oh my gosh, it's the best. And then you can smell like peaches every day. Yeah, it's that like plum color. It is made for your eyes.
I'm ready to go out.
I know.
I'm gonna tell my husband.
I'm gonna take you out on, what is it, Wednesday?
Wow. And I like the eyelashes.
I knew you would like the lashes. I love them.
And these lipsticks.
You're gorgeous. You were perfect.
Wow. Julie, woo.
Well, thank you.
I love
thank
it.
You for being my model. It was so fun to have you. And thank you, everybody, for watching. It was so much fun. I'm live every weeknight, 7:30 Pacific Standard Time. Bye, guys. Thank you.